for the WCW World Tag Team Championships, Mike, and I don't think Kevin Nash and or the NWO have enough money in their checking account to cover all the power bombs Scott Steiner may put on Kevin Monday night.
Well, I'm just wondering, there have been problems, obviously, in the camp of the New World Order. And it's been very obvious that Rick and Scott Steiner have not been on the same page for the past month or so. This is going to be a very intriguing matchup, and the World Tag Team title belts are at stake this Monday on Nitro from El Paso, Texas.
Well, finally, Wolfpack rules or no, Hall and Nash will defend the tag team titles against the Steiners. And this goes back, we could talk for the rest of the hour about the situation between the Outsiders and the Steiners. This goes back a year and a half or more.
Well, remember,
guys have been at each other's throats.
Sure, the Steiner brothers on several occasions had the tag team belts. They had beaten the Outsiders in matches, only to have the decisions overruled and overturned, have those championship belts returned to Hall and Nash. And then the Outsiders came up with those bogus tag team titles.
Exactly.
And finally, a quote-unquote unification match was signed, with the Outsiders being victorious. As a result, Nash and Hall have the tag belts, but they go on the line this Monday on Nitro against Rick and Scott.
Next up on Saturday night, the Biggin from Wigan, veteran competitor Chris Adams, and also a veteran, Brad Armstrong. This should be a good one, Mike.
Two very experienced wrestlers going head-to-head. Brad Armstrong, talk about a change in attitude.
Oh, please.
He's really had a rougher edge for the past few months, and he's going to need to avoid at all costs that deadly super kick of Chris Adams.
Armstrong, reversal by Adams into the corner. Hip toss by Adams. Nicely done. Nice snap on that. And Armstrong, a little shove in the chest. But Adams, whoa, that dropped Armstrong. That's a shove right there.
Scott, following this Monday's Nitro in El Paso, Nitro will be going to Tampa, Florida on Monday, February the 16th. Then on February the 23rd, we're headed out west to Sacramento, California, and the Arco Arena, March the 2nd. It's Nitro in Philadelphia at the Core State Spectrum.
Oh, the city of brotherly love explodes when Nitro comes to town. Side headlock now by Chris Adams. Adams, as we said, a veteran, goes back. Remember the dynamic duo with Adams and the late Gino Hernandez a long time ago? Adams, tag team competitor, was at one time a tag team partner of Terry Taylor. Whatever happened to Terry Taylor?
Well, that really comes to mind, and it with the Texas tour that WCW has been on, because of Chris Adams and Gino Hernandez. They just about ran the Lone Star State for several years, didn't they?
They certainly did. And Chris Adams, it's great to have him in WCW, and he's in a singles competitive match with Brad Armstrong. And Armstrong arguing with the official already. It's hard to believe the change that's come over Brad Armstrong. I'm certain that Bullet Bob is not at all proud of his son here.
Well, if you talk to Brad Armstrong, he says that he is ready to do just about anything within his power to stop the Armstrong curse. And he obviously thinks that by taking a little bit rougher, a little bit harder edge to his wrestling style, that's going to be the thing to take him over the top.
Okay. All right. Okay, Mike, I've been handed yet another missive from the Executive Committee of World Championship Wrestling. We have been informed that our announcement is still to come, but it will be a match added to Super Brawl 8. We thought earlier it may be the announcement of a special guest referee for Hogan and Singh. It is not that. We will have an announcement regarding an additional match for Super Brawl. That's all we know thus far. We will have that sometime before the end of the program, hopefully sometime before Raven and Benoit go at it in our main event.
That's right. Don't go anywhere, because the Canadian crippler, Chris Benoit, is going to try and put that crippler crossface on Raven. We know that Raven will try and counter with the deadly DDT.
That's still to come, as is Eddie Guerrero and Silver King. Once again, that's going to be all over the place. Silver King certainly has shown me a lot over the last couple of months, but it's all been in six-man tag. He's in there against one of the most double-tough competitors in WCW, Eddie Guerrero. That's still to come.
And do not underestimate the ability of Silver King. You take one look at his physique. He's a stocky individual. You might not think that he'll be able to take it up to the lights and fly like the other luchadors, where you're sadly mistaken. We're really looking forward to that one-on-one matchup, Eddie Guerrero and Silver King. That also yet to come tonight on Saturday night.
Rear chinlock by Brad Armstrong on Chris Adams. Chris Adams certainly well-versed in the submission-type school of wrestling, but Brad Armstrong not doing a bad job himself with some extra added leverage. feet over the bottom rope.
Armstrong just neutralizing Adams at this point, keeping him off his feet, taking him down to the mat, and again using that bottom strand of ropes.
Are you using these ropes in here?
No, sir. Coming up Monday night on Nitro, we saw him earlier. We saw him last week just take apart Ming and Jimmy Hart. Bill Goldberg will be on Nitro. We talked earlier about Eddie Guerrero. Eddie is also on Nitro in addition to that big World Tag Team title match when the Wolfpack, the Outsiders, Scott Hall and Kevin Nash defend against Rick and Scott Steiner. And don't forget the great unknown out there, the equalizer, Ted DiBiase. Anything the NWO does, DiBiase can meet and equalize from his ringside position.
And that matchup is intriguing on so many fronts. Will Rick and Scott Steiner be able to put aside their differences for one night because of the importance of that matchup? The World Tag Team titles at stake.
Brad Armstrong missing with the dropkick on Chris Adams. Adams now follows up with a right hand. Whoa! That rocked Armstrong. So did that one.
I think the main reason behind Brad Armstrong's offense to this point has been to avoid the super kick at all costs. Big power slam, covered by Adams, and gets a two count.
Well, Armstrong is not the mat wrestler that Chris Adams is. I don't think he'll argue that point, but he knows if he takes it vertical, he's setting himself up for that super kick from Chris Adams. That's why we've stayed on the mat most of this match. Adams laying the forearms across the back of the head into the neck of Brad Armstrong.
Well, he just rode him down to the mat and just delivered those clubbing blows to the back of the head, and that has Brad Armstrong reeling.
Oh, there it is!
He was not able to avoid the super kick.
Chris Adams, the super kick on Brad Armstrong, and Brad Armstrong,
Hold on one second. That's Glacier.
What in the world is Glacier doing out here? Now, wait a second.
Well, he applauded Chris Adams.
Now, Glacier, he won his contest earlier over the cat, or he lost the contest to the cat.
Yeah, I came out earlier after I got through beating Ernest the Cat Miller's brains out.
What?
Decided to watch a few matches, including yours. And I gotta say, you move pretty good for a man your age.
Uh-oh.
But you use a move looks an awful lot like a move I use. My kick, the Granite Kick, the move I made famous.
Wait a minute.
The move.
He's saying that he made the cryonic kick famous. Chris Adams did it a long time before.
Listen here, boy.
Oh,
I was using the original super kick when you were a punk kid in the first row, wishing you were a wrestler.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what? Now I know what the Beatles feel like. But I'm going to tell you what. I'm going to tell you what. I'll only do too happy to show you how it should be done.
No, Mr. Adams. No, look.
Now, all of a sudden, Glacier has respect for Chris Adams.
No, he should. Glacier could have his teeth knocked out by that super kick. He better take the powder here quick. Ho-ho!
Glacier trying to revise history. Chris Adams gets the win. Glacier bails out. Adams, the victor on Saturday night.